My name is Tina, and I am an average consumer. I buy stuff. I dabble in local and organic. I lazily read labels. Packaged food is my staple. I forget my cloth bags. Meh. Daily food to go. I drink from straws without feeling like a sucker. And those red cups, too. I even collect cheap plastic glasses. Oh, what fun! Everything is at my fingertips. I'm carefree, thoughtless. But what can a girl do? One day, I have an epiphany that changes my life. I am going to quit plastic. I've been totally oblivious to the repercussions of my disposable ways. The ocean I love is turning into a plastic soup. Plastic garbage mars every beach, infringing on a connection I hold sacred. News of dead whales filled with plastic bags entangled in plastic nets breaks my heart. Baby birds on far-off islands, plastic-induced starvation. What a mess. An epiphany is great and all, but to make sure I actually get myself out of this mess, it needs to be a challenge. And the first rule will be, no new plastic for 1 year.
For an entire year. No new plastic for an entire year.
This is what my boyfriend thinks of the project.
Worst idea ever.
What do you mean?
Ever.
I also recruit 14 other people to join my challenge with a goal of no new plastic for 1 year. I get them to sign a waiver because none of us are quite sure where this is going to go.
I'm aware that the project may be challenging and may cause emotional, psychological, physical, financial, and social hardships, and that my life could be altered in any number of ways through my participation.
We're doing a plastic-free year.
I'm examining my wares and thinking about all the things I will have to give up.
I love yogurt.
Yogurt? Chips? Shampoo? We're all so reliant on this material.
You can see there's a lot of plastic in that.
I am by no means prepared, but certainly determined. My challengers are also fixated on the things they will have to give up.
We're definitely nervous. I know it's a lot to get into.
I wouldn't have thought about doing anything like this. I grew up in Ontario, typical kind of suburbia. I always go to the mall, just whatever's easiest, right?
We've been trying to reduce plastic, but we're not there 100% yet. There's certain items, certain things that I'm probably nervous about.
We've gone a bit more hungry, I suspect, over the short term, that's for darn sure.
No smokies for a year. A year without boxed cereal, I don't know how I'm going to do.
No different cereals for the year?
The Ziplocs and how we, I know. Always have things sealed in the Ziplocs and...
Yeah, I guess. I think it's going to be a challenge either way. And I just felt like if Marnie was going to do it, then, like, you know, I'd like to try to do it.
It's going to be tough. Food's in plastic. It's everywhere.
So definitely looking for tips on how to take it to the next level.
The clock ticks towards midnight on December 31st. I gorge on plastic-wrapped chocolate. One last time.
Three, two, one.
purge the kitchen and bathroom of all plastics.
I don't really know where to start, to be honest.
The reasons for the cold turkey approach are the following. One, to become aware of where all the plastics in our lives are coming from.
Let's start with this cover.
Two, to start with a clean slate and force ourselves to come up with alternatives, even the hard stuff.
Throw it in.
Three, to get rid of stuff that is potentially harmful to our health. You may or may not know that plastic itself is toxic, with its chemical additives that tend to leach out. But many toxic things also live inside plastic bottles and bags. By eliminating plastic, you are reducing your exposure to a lot of bad stuff. The kitchen and bathroom being the most common hiding places for these offenders.
We're gonna need a bigger bin. This is a scary pile.
Do you know that the average person uses 500 plastic bags a year? That is absurd.
Look how many bags you have.
So before I met you, babe.
How deep?
When I ask my friends why they still use them, they say they need them for either garbage bags or for picking up dog poo. I'll get back to those 2 points later.
Polypropylene, 100% plastic. Oh man.
Goodbye, Tostitos. Do I get to keep my hat?
I have to say I'm rather oblivious to how Brandon might be feeling. I am kind of imposing this challenge on him, but at this point, he's still being a good sport.
For those of you who don't know, plastic, every single piece of plastic on the face of the earth will never go away.
It's true. Plastic is made from petroleum products. A surprising number of people don't know that. But now that you do, the next and most important thing you need to know about plastic is that it does not biodegrade on land or in water. Therefore, like Brandon said, nearly every piece of plastic ever created is still on this planet and will be for thousands of years. Exposed to the elements, plastic simply breaks down into smaller and smaller bits. You can imagine the vast accumulation that is occurring on our planet. Think about your own plastics, most of which you probably use for a very short time, but will never go away. Now, take that to a global scale and it amounts to disastrous consequences. Next time you reach for that crinkly convenience, just think on that. Plastic is forever. Wait, you say. I recycle. What's the point of this movie? You might even boldly call yourself zero waste with your apt recycling skills.
You know, I try and use less, I try and do lots of recycling, and I even do the alternative recycling.
Maybe we shouldn't all be so proud of how full our bins are, because plastic recycling is a bit of a myth.
Really?
No film about plastic would be complete without a few fine words from Manuel Maqueda and Captain Charles Moore. The captain is my hero. The guy is seriously awesome. He can basically be attributed for bringing the plastic crisis to mainstream attention. Let's hear what he has to say about recycling.
What we're doing is we're putting it in that third bin. We're getting fooled. We're going to these municipal recycling facilities, these materials recovery facilities that are just assembly lines where you have a conveyor belt and you're cherry picking just the best stuff. And still the lion's share of what you're putting in that bin is going to the landfill or getting burned. Because plastic is not simple to recycle. I call it diddly point squat. That's how much we recycle. It's just not happening.
Manuel is my mentor for all things plastic.
The idea that we can also recycle plastic, you know, what a brilliant scam. It's not happening. I mean, just putting things in a bin and they disappear, where do they go? It's brilliant. So people keep buying, consuming.
Downcycling is a better term. See, you can't take one plastic bottle and turn it into another plastic bottle in perpetuity, as the classic recycling symbol suggests. Rather, you take that bottle and turn it into a lower grade plastic product. That new product often can't be recycled further and ends up trashed, breaking the cycle.
Glass or metal, at least there's some value. You can create another bottle from one bottle or another glass container from one glass container. So that's kind of one-to-one recycling. With plastic, it's not happening. You can create maybe a doormat. But how many doormats do you go through? You know, how many doormats do you need? But plastic bottles is something that we're using all the time. And with that kind of downcycling, first, you're just delaying the arrival of the plastic to the landfill. Also, you're not stemming the need for more plastic to make more bottles. It's a deception scheme. So I'm really upset about the whole idea of recycling, as it is right now.
I don't want to spend my life cleaning something that is basically garbage and that is going to be melted down anyway and made into stuff that we probably don't really need.
Because where does this go? Who recycles this? Nobody.
Not to mention the plastic that never even makes it into the recycling bins and goes straight to the dump. Or ends up in the ocean via the wind and water. An estimated 20 million tons of plastic a year comes from land and makes up 80% of the plastic floating out there. What more?
We're getting lied to. People are stamping biodegradable on things that show no change in compost piles.
Given these unnerving truths, I have to arm myself and my challengers with a new message. Refuse.
Change again? You know, I finally got it all figured out.
The new message is indeed a little more intense, but item by item, we just have to give it a go. Back to my kitchen.
This is plastic mountain, Keisha. This is dangerous territory.
I don't know where to put it.
Feeling a little paralyzed, knowing what we do about plastic, we simply move the mountain onto our back porch. What have the others found hidding in their cupboards?
Floor cleaner, a glass cleaner, a counter cleaner, a toilet cleaner, a bathroom cleaner.
Tons of these like popsicle stick things, a bit of everything.
And we hosted like a Hawaiian theme party with straws.
Plastic forks.
10 different colors of icing.
So this used to be my plastic cupboard. I wish I had a before picture, but I couldn't get the door closed because it had oozed out here and here. This was all plastic, this was all plastic. And all the glass jars were in the very back corner.
My first thought was, I don't use that much plastic. Looking in my kitchen cupboards is what changed my mind. It was a good eye-opener for me about how much plastic we were still going through. Oh, it's a bit frightening that spread out through the apartment every day.
Have you smelled your plastics lately?
Oh, we have some leftover plastic from the trip to England. We'll have to consume those at some point.
Next was the bathroom purge. Goodbye, strange and stinky, chemical-laden products that I probably didn't need in the first place and which have been doing me more harm than good. I am left with a very small assortment of items with a few new additions.
Coconut oil for skincare, toothpaste powder, lip balm in a paper tube, a deodorant bar, and then deodorant paste, shampoo and conditioner for me, and then for Keisha as well, and then the NatraCare pads, which are plastic-free.
Three things I am particularly excited about are, one, a toothbrush made of bone and boar hairs, which unfortunately arrives in the mail with about 10 toothbrushes worth of plastic.
Tastes like a wet pig.
Two, an organic hemp shower curtain to replace the awful PVC one, which emits plastic fumes when heated with the shower.
A toilet brush becomes a big deal.
Like, three, a toilet brush that looks like a hedgehog on a stick.
Wicked toilet brush.
And so yeah, I'm like 2 days into the baking soda trial. But it's working really well. We keep the baking soda up here in a nice little glass jar. And we keep it a little bit wet so it's easier to get out. Take a light paste like that. Boom, 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 boom. You won't smell me all day. The reality is the other stuff I was using, like, just masked. Like, I still stunk. I just stunk with a little hint of something.
We went to Lush and then got facial scrubs as well.
Revolutionary, innovative tooth cleaning tabs.
I'm going to attempt here to achieve the breath of God. All right, who wants to give it a test?
Once you're forced to look, you find that there really are many alternatives out there. That is, for those things you have determined you actually need.
I can't believe how hard foundation, like, or a cover-up?
Yeah.
Like, it's ridiculous. Like, boys live without this, like, every day of their lives. But for me, it's like my emergency. What if something happens?
Yeah, a big makeup person. So it was very difficult to kind of get rid of that stuff. I totally feel naked right now.
I have a similar addiction to mascara.
Can I put this one back?
But after a highly unsuccessful and messy attempt at making my own,
I've managed to squeeze some aloe out. Just put some charcoal powder in here and mix it up. This is looking suspect. Oh my God, I'm gonna put this stuff on my eyes.
It's so vain, isn't it? To go through such lengths to apply like the thinnest little layer of black.
The verdict is I need help. There's charcoal everywhere. I've made a huge mess.
My eyes look the same,
except now the difference is I have charcoal also on my face.
I am just going to have to go without.
Very lonely looking.
In any case, when you strip your belongings down just to the bare bones, the remaining items, chosen with care, become much more meaningful and valuable.
Some soap?
Which is how it should be, I think.
That's all we got left.
Getting rid of all things plastic was good. Our house feels fresh and somehow more sophisticated.
Yeah,
it feels
definitely.
Less clutter, yeah.
Yeah, cluttered. Way less clutter. It's nice.
Let the games begin. It doesn't last long before the plastic starts coming back. Someone put some garbage in my drink on day one. And with that begins my plastic collection.
They had the plastic creamers and the straws to stir your coffee and things like that. And I asked for milk on the side and a little metal container and used my cutlery to stir my coffee. So we'd been, you know, trying to play by the rules for the first few moments we were out on New Year's Day. And then our ketchup showed up in a plastic container. A few dabs of ketchup, yeah. And this, that will be here, you know, forever and ever because of it. It's ridiculous.
An easier approach to avoiding plastic? Just hide in your house like Andrew and Lynette have been doing.
Oh, okay, we're clean.
No new plastic.
We're clean.
We're
no,
doing good
no
so far.
New.
We're
no,
good so far.
That was from the freezer.
I like her word choice, clean. Does wasting make us feel dirty? Speaking of cleaning,
soap nuts. They're plain old berries. And I'm just gonna watch these suckers boil for a few minutes. And there I have an entire jar of cleaning liquid. Ooh, like magic.
Matt and Sarah are also getting set up with new alternatives.
Yeah, you just kind of make it into a paste. I'll just make it in here. And then this is just dish soap that we got from the soap dispensary. So we buy like all of our toilet paper, our toothbrushes, our shampoo, conditioner, and everything from there.
Even if you break it down and are pretty simple with what you use, it's still a lot. So to have businesses helping you make that choice and do the research for you, it's a good thing.
Baking soda and dish soap.
It's just so freaking easy to do these things, and I wish we had known about it before.
It's cheaper and it's easier, so much easier. And then you don't like choke from the fumes, especially when you clean the bathroom.
We're making some good progress, but
looking at this first month's collection, it's clear that takeout waste is what my big problem is. I didn't realize that this was plastic, this was Indian takeout, this fork. Again, someone just shoved it in somewhere. Ew. Few straws. There is plastic in here. Sushi grass.
The verdict? Room for improvement.
Given my failures in the takeout department, my friend made me this awesome thing that I think will help a lot. It's a takeout cutlery set, and it's got everything I need to avoid plastic on the road. Even has a stainless steel and a glass straw.
At the end of the first month, the group and I have a Plastics Anonymous meeting to compare notes.
What's been hard for you?
You know, going shopping and
and you see these people with their baskets with 40 plastic bags with, you know, one or two items in each.
It's an adventure, but sometimes an adventure isn't what you want. Sometimes you just want to go to the store and get your thing.
So now we just don't eat very much. Losing a little bit of weight.
We're all on a diet.
Our fridge is rather sparse.
Dinner's ready, honey.
Excellent.
Lovely dinner.
We're all struggling a little, but it does feel good to check in. Doing the challenge with other people allows for support, sharing, and accountability. We have also started a social media group for the same purposes. It's working great.
Jen needs help. The plastic is seducing her.
What is the object of desire?
Try Boat Trail Mix. Two handfuls keeps me satisfied.
Save on Foods has bulk Cheetos.
Speaking of great.
Everything, but Rose went to a party today. In all the other goodie bags, there were little gummies wrapped in plastic, but Rose got a special gift.
This is the rock.
Rose, you rock. Lynette and Andrew were missing from the PA meeting. How has the first month treated them?
I felt like I was losing you guys for a little bit.
If life is really busy, it's hard to, at least for a new habit you're trying to establish, I think it gets trickier to really remain mindful of it. There was definitely times where I would come home and be like, damn this plastic-free challenge.
It's not convenient.
I don't want to do this. But I, you know, never gave it up. In terms of trying to reduce the amount of plastic we use, that's a pretty cool act of citizenship, I think. And anytime you can become more self-reliant or extricate yourself from reliance on those oil-related products, you're in a better place to be a free citizen, I think.
What about Marnie and Edward?
Yeah.
They, too, are experiencing some growing pains.
We've just really realized that it's like the convenience factor is definitely the hardest thing, and you come to rely on the convenience of like packaged foods, and hugely for us it's been snacks.
Hungry.
Like as the other day it was like, after this year I'm done, I'm out, we're back to plastic.
Stupid plastic.
He doesn't stop for lunch, so he comes home and he's immediately starving and needs snacks.
A little boring, but that's all we got.
This is horrible. All I want is chips. I think we might continue to have little meltdowns.
No snacks.
Has quitting crossed your mind?
No. Okay. Well, there's the ideal and then there's reality. We need to just make it work for us.
Indeed, it's not worth giving up the challenge for the sake of a few items. Just choose your vices carefully and keep on trucking.
I mean, you kind of get used to the food scene in that first month that you start.
Yeah, that's a tough one.
And then you just, each week, each month, there's a new thing that you hadn't thought about.
These interviews highlight the importance of a long-term commitment, in our case, a full year. True to its properties, plastic doesn't go down easy.
I find I'm not entirely trained yet.
It's time to train.
Shake a box, squeeze a box. Find those hidden bags.
There's totally a bag inside this box.
This is butcher paper.
If it rips clean, it's paper. If it stretches or peels, it's plastic.
You can see the fibers of plastic.
Anticipate. Scope out what plastics are possibly coming your way. Make a rule or two so you're not overwhelmed come decision time.
You know, we want to eat organic, locally sourced stuff, but if it comes wrapped in a ton of plastic and there's a conventional potato right next to it, but no plastic,
yes.
Which one do you go for?
Repurpose.
Beer bottle, now shampoo holder.
Keep it simple.
We're making bread.
Learn how to cook rather than just warm food.
It's all about experimentation.
Broken? Fix it. If not, look back in time. You can also look back to the future. Lie.
order your food for here and then take it off the plate and then bring it with you.
Oh, I'll just go ahead and grab myself a mushroom bag here.
Steal.
Now we have some plastic-free snacks. Should be Cajun mix.
You go into your favorite health food store and all of a sudden it's a hellish scene, you know, it's plastic everywhere.
Get acquainted with this place.
Yeah, so I have a jar.
Good things live here, I promise. Then, practice the art of the refill.
Plastic free shopping does require that you get bits and pieces here and there. And I know that we can get bulk maple syrup here. The sweet goodness is filling. Oh! Uh-oh! Uh-oh! How do you turn it off? I got too excited.
Use your tools. Be hard on yourself. You won't forget your bags next time. Temptation lurks around every corner. Resist. Keep walking, Darren. Learn to say no. I don't want it. I don't use it. I can't have it. I'm allergic. Whatever works. Learn to ask for what you want. I want. Instead, could I have? Please. Thank you. And just give me that. Be creative, but if you do get stuck, just ask Beth Terry. Use plastic only as a last resort when you really have no other option.
Thank God for this banana cutter.
Well, it's funny how fast you can change your perspective. Before, you just didn't notice it, and then it starts to get under your skin a bit too.
A bit under your skin is becoming somewhat of an understatement in some of our cases. Darren was perhaps the biggest skeptic at the beginning.
Is plastic evil?
He had only committed to 3 personal goals.
No coffee in takeaway disposable cups, no pop or bottled water in plastic containers, and not have disposable plastic bags from Subway.
By April, he is dominating the airwaves on our social media page.
My bike ride to Saturday morning soccer is not the same as before this challenge. I don't see lovely forests. I saw garbage lining the roads. I broke a plastic hanger trying to hastily hang a sweater in my closet. A metal one wouldn't have broken so easily. When we went to the public skate, they insisted that we wear plastic wristbands. Another plastic commodity is shampoo. I used to use dollops daily. Oh no!
My wife always said it was
the glasses were packaged in plastic. Yesterday at lunch, I had an O. Henry bar. Today, at coffee, I had then I looked and saw 2 little straws in both Lorelai's and my water glasses. Ah! I had Owen to go to a birthday party. And Owen had a piece of cake with a plastic fork. I was trying to talk him into, why don't you eat it like a hot dog? Can't you eat it with your hands? What I should have done, I should have given him 2 options. I should have said, you can eat the cake with your hands or no cake.
My, Darren. I'm getting a little grumpy too.
Did you notice this bottle has an eco cap? This is part of our ongoing effort to reduce our impact on the environment. This bottle and cap contain an average of 20% less plastic than our original
Earth bottle
shape. Bottle and cap. Be green. We can all make a difference.
Plastic sushi grass. I don't know what item could be more annoying and more useless than this. Let's put a piece of garbage on a sushi plate. 2 California rolls and a yam tempura roll, but no sushi grass. When I turned my back, they double wrapped my plate. Oh. For me, coming to the beach isn't really the same anymore. Whenever I come to the beach, I end up like sorting through the sand and really having a hard time chilling out. Tim Hortons and other coffee lids are so common. I see so many of them. Billions of these must get used every day. And like the disposal is pretty careless. paper cups. You can see how degraded the paper is, but then you see, there it is. There's the plastic lining right there that's fully intact. You can just peel it right off the inside of the cup. It's a hidden plastic. It hides in its paper mask. We drive past this lovely collection of children's toys. You know, like you think you're doing something great for the kids. Let's see what their world looks like when they grow up. Like, take a box. Take a bunch of pillows and make a frickin' fort. You don't need this, like, cheap crap. Where's this made anyway? Doesn't even say came from hell, probably.
So how's the plastic challenge going, Tyna?
Cameraman! Tell me about the plastic challenge!
Well, I don't know, it's going pretty well. Other than that plastic spoon that you got in your coffee today, that was kind of a bummer.
Look at all the bulk soil. Super excited about this. It's gonna be awesome. No plastic.
So I tried to get someone to help me to put the soil into my containers and they wouldn't let me. I tried every possible combination of creative solutions that would allow me to avoid their thick plastic bag. I feel like I'm living on this different planet. Like, what planet am I living in that I can't get soil that's sitting in front of me into a bucket? Like, this is ridiculous. So anyway, I'm gonna call the head office. Hi there, I have a complaint to make about service I received at one of your stores.
Here we go, my ultimate low.
I really just want some soil. Like, it's so frustrating. It's really, really frustrating. It really ruined my day. It's just because I'm trying to do something good. Why does it have to be so hard?
In the end, the owner of the garden store chain came and shoveled dirt into my containers herself. Through this experience, I learned to use my voice, and when in doubt, tears.
You do get support from other people, and when people do things like that, it really feels good because you're always kind of on the outsider, crazy type person.
Now to our one-woman campaign to clean up the environment.
Kind of the crazy plastics lady now. Been trying very hard all 5 months so far to not acquire any plastics. And this is the result. There's a big hose of plastics. And I'm going like this, you know, like, just stop.
Plastic is useful, no denying that. It's just that we're abusing this material that is intended to last a really long time for short-term disposable uses. These disposable products make up 80% of the problem, hence they are the focus of our challenge. And plastic food packaging makes up the bulk of our efforts. However, let's not forget that all non-disposable plastics were out too. The help is there, not only because I feel I'm being bombarded with these products all day, every day, but because I am in deep, admittedly too deep. I have a new identity through my blog, Plastic Manners, and people are even starting to recognize me. Hi.
Hi, I just started reading your blog, I think.
Oh, awesome. You did? I wonder how she knew that it was me. The first kind of big moment in this project was when David Suzuki posted my blog on his Facebook. I like opened my thing. I had like, you have 60 new comments. I was like, what? My blog went from like a few views to 1,536 views in one day. So should we do one more
round?
Me, me, me. But how is Brandon doing? Well, he is generally supportive, as seen here dutifully holding a sign. He often takes on the role of antagonist. He blatantly buys plastic items or simply doesn't even bother trying to avoid them.
What? What?
Most of the time, he just wants to relax. So ultimately, we make a rule that the P word cannot be brought up on dates. And that helps.
Slowly, we make improvements. Brandon may hate almost every minute of it, but he obliges. And I know he enjoys a few things, like this homemade iced tea. The guy got giddy as a schoolgirl when he made his own.
Salsa.
It's 5 months in to the challenge. We're at May. We're in May.
Sucky!
And the plastic pile is still here. So the good news is that Brandon's got a week off work, and I've tasked him to take care of the mountain of plastic. So soon we're gonna have our porch back.
So basically what Tyne is saying is, I'm on donkey duty.
Yeehaw! Yeehaw!
What's with all this crap on the deck here? That is cardboard, that is allowed. Plastic must go.
I sent Brandon to the store. I dumped out the items that I sent him to get. And this came out. It's red curry paste in the offending substance. Brandon!
What's up?
Well, what's this all about?
What?
What's this all about?
Because I'm gonna cook you dinner one night. Nice curry dinner. No? Sunny out.
Brandon broke up with me. Maybe you saw it coming, but I was blindsided. It isn't until much later that I finally ask him what role plastic played in our demise.
Like, remember we used to fight in grocery stores?
Oh, I remember.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, I had asked her to wrap it in wax paper or whatever, and then she did it in the plastic, and I was just like, oh. It was like bringing a horrible report card home to your parents. That's what it felt like. Like, oh, doing the slow walk down the aisle. Tyne.
And of course, I want to see whether he has gone back to plastic. As he fumbles to make me coffee, the evidence presents itself.
This is the offending cupboard right here. What do you know?
Do we need to do another purge?
Oh God, no.
Anyway, after the breakup, I move into my van. Not by the river, but in a back alley. I depressively watch people bringing out their trash and spend a lot of time wondering what the point of putting myself through all this is. I even succumb to retail therapy.
Because a girl's gotta do what a girl's gotta do. As you can see, the whole dress is pretty much plastic. I don't know. I might take it back. But anyway, I just wasn't even thinking.
I need to regroup. I plan a trip to a plastic event. But first, a few preparations.
Good afternoon. How may I help you?
Hi there. This is Tyne Uitto calling. I made an online booking, and I kind of have a strange request for you. I was wondering if you could help me out.
I could certainly try.
I'm doing a plastic-free year, trying not to acquire any new plastics this year. I realized that online, it didn't give me a chance to order no meal on the airplane.
Okay.
And so I wondered if there was a way to let the airline or something know that I don't want a meal at all. It necessitated me to choose one of the options.
I see. Fair enough. Yeah. To be perfectly honest, no, I don't think there is. You're the first I've ever had asked for that in 9 years, that they don't want a meal. So, to be perfectly honest, Tyne, I don't think there's any way to avoid that.
I've been doing a little inventory of the plastics that have been coming my way during the trip here. And I have a little collection here in front of me. Headphone set. The blanket is wrapped in plastic, so I've collected my cameraman's food items here. I guess the regular Joe flyer.
It's not hard to bring a water bottle to fill after security, a cup for in-flight drinks, and to pack a lunch. Bring a headset and a sweater. None of this is rocket science. Just one thing I didn't anticipate. Muscle memory gets the best of me. Now, how do I collect that? A much-needed pep talk with Manuel.
We were looking forward to our first beer together. And listen to this.
Plastic.
Listen to this. Cheers.
No, there's nothing happy about that sound.
And then, to the TEDx event, where I feel proud to be connected to this incredible network.
When we've done everything we can as a consumer, and we need something, and we're not willing to do without it, and we can't find it used, and we can't make it ourselves, we get to a point where we have to ask for what we want. When I decided I wanted to use soap nuts to do my laundry, I could only find it packaged in plastic, and so I wrote to the company and asked them to change their packaging, and a month later, they did, just because I asked.
Mirror, mirror in my hand. Whose job is it to take a stand? I hope that we shall someday see a beach, a wave that's plastic free.
And once the baby turtles are born, if they can get up through the sand, avoiding the plastic in the sand, out into the ocean, they're very lucky. But sometimes they get into the ocean and their first meal is plastic. That's wrong, but that's our reality.
We'll see a few more of these talks yet. But how about a little more from this eco-hottie?
Pay attention to what people who are trying to manipulate you to do things and buy things that are bad for you and bad for our planet. I mean, the most important thing you can do is sit, be still, think about it, really feel how you feel, and then get up and make your plan for how you can be part of the growing movement.
Brandon, who? Ha! In all seriousness, Jay's words strike a chord. I know I'm on the right path. Onward.
So we're here in downtown Vancouver, and we're trying to make a stink about plastic pollution again. We placed this ginormous six-pack ring on a few statues now. The first attempt was unsuccessful. We've been told that this location's okay, so we're gonna leave it up here and hope people have a look and rethink their own plastic use.
Here's something to keep in mind the next time you buy a six-pack of beer or a pop. Environmental activists spent the day hanging that, a giant six-pack ring, around wildlife sculptures downtown, symbolically choking them.
It's a catastrophe and it's inexcusable, really.
So if you do buy a six-pack held together by plastic rings, the activists ask you to please snip each ring before you recycle it.
That's so not what we were saying. Well, any media is good media.
That's really neat to just be able to share my experiences, what works, and my rationale behind doing it. Encourage other people to give it a try as well.
Refuse things instead of accepting them. Reduce what you do need to consume. Reuse what you can and recycle the rest.
We really do need to bring more attention to the plastic, and I think we've been successful today. I've never had so many pictures taken. If I do tell them about our plastic-free pledge, they don't understand that it's a possibility.
A few months have made a big difference. A certain confidence has clearly replaced the jitters. At another event, Matt and Sarah are showcasing their do-it-yourself skills.
It's getting easier, I think. You don't think of things as much because things just kind of happen naturally now.
When we go shopping, we kind of know where's safe and what's not safe. Like, we've scouted out pretty much the stores that are, you know, won't put up a fuss.
Sarah treats this very much like a competition.
This is my first piece of plastic. It's all lined in plastic, this whole thing.
There's no more competitive thing in the world than not getting plastic.
That's true.
It's serious.
In terms of the reduction of plastic, a lot of it is just second nature now. Like, I would say, you know, in terms of the diversion, like, we're easily in the 90, high 90 some odd percentage. It doesn't seem as hard anymore. The first month or two is that steeper learning curve, and then I think it just kind of settled out. Like, packaging, to me, now seems inconvenient. Someone says, do you need a grocery bag? I'm like, no, keep that thing away from me. Like, I don't even want to have to deal with that. I don't want to have to think about it. So just being able to throw all the ingredients just in my own cloth bag is kind of liberating. There's some deli we go to a lot less often now because you got to haggle with an old lady because she doesn't want to learn how to tear, and she's like, oh, great. Or she just gives you a look, and you're like, you've just had a long day. You're like, I don't want to deal with that lady.
We're all getting familiar with those looks.
We actually can't do that. It's a sanitary thing.
What are you talking about?
You have to have plastic.
It's being kind of trivialized. Currently, certain things are really ingrained, and it needs someone to, like, plant the seed, and down the road, they're going to, you know, see it for what it is.
We had some issues and we made a couple more exceptions around them, but since then it's been pretty easy sailing.
The first 3 months went by pretty fast and I was surprised that we'd got through the first quarter. It's not a competition, it's not really a challenge. I just want to change the way that we live our life, creating so much garbage and always having things around in the house that has a logo staring at you. It's saying no to the old system and creating your own new system. And you don't know what the new system is until you actually live it. I am trying to work on the convenience factor for us leaving the house so anyone can grab their to-go items. But unless you're organized for that stuff, then you're going to go back to the old convenience. Create it, get the system right, and it will be convenient. Love you, have a nice day.
You too.
I've got room for things like this, for boxes of milk bottles and places back here for jars of food, instead of them being hidden away in cupboards that you can't really see. I wanted a transparent kitchen so I could see what was on hand. We're going to start freezing our own food. I have moved towards the mason jar. Some of the Abigo wraps are just on their own, and then some of them have this, but that's what we put the cheese in. Fridge especially, I find, is hard for the plastics. Baking cupboard, very easy stuff to get to because it's all bulk. All of the containers. Right down here is all the cleaning stuff, so I just have to take these back to refill, for example. There's the beeswax, the dishwasher stuff. And then there's vinegar, baking soda, all of that stuff back there. So here's a question. Lint, we were wondering if we could compost this, but I think there's going to be way too much plastic because our clothes are made of plastic these days.
Sadly so. And when you wash, say, a fleece made of water bottles, thousands of plastic filaments are released into the water, per garment, per load. Do we think we can get away with it? Plastic is so abundant in the oceans that it is readily ingested by creatures out there, including those we eat. What sucks even more is that plastics in the oceans act as magnets for pollutants, so much so that you can have a plastic bit that is a million times more toxic than the surrounding water. Yum.
Someone is weird enough to say, I'm going to refuse plastic, and they're doing okay. We're doing okay, aren't we? We're still alive. We eat when we can.
Just okay. I'm having a great time. But weird, I'll give you that. Where we live, the only way to get plastic-free dairy is to go straight to the source. Aside from that, I have also joined a cow herd share. The milk is unpasteurized, so I have to pick it up every week from a secret back alley location.
937. I swear that was the code.
I'm such a moron.
Success. The cap gets reused over and over again. There's a new sticker on it that says, not for human consumption.
Overboard? Maybe. But it seems worth it to avoid creating waste.
Yeah, zero waste to me isn't, you know, collecting, you know, 10 large garbage bags of mobile recycling items. To me now, I look at that more as irresponsibility.
We've kind of gone the way of not creating that waste. Our garbage consumption now is a paper bag.
In order to use those paper bags, though, we have to get rid of the wet stuff first.
And these are red wigglers. They're specifically a compost worm.
What a great feeling to lose the burden of waste and instead play with worms.
Plants, and I realized they were the first pets that I've had since I left home, like 6 or 7 years ago.
Have you seen those decals on the back of cars? And they show how many kids they have. So I thought we would get Andrew and me and then a bunch of little squiggles.
Now that we've checked off one of those excuses for using plastic bags, garbage, I did promise to tell you what I do about dog poop.
When the girl's gotta go, she's gotta go. But this is a great demonstration of what I do when the dog takes a poo. So then now what we do, because of course I don't have any plastic, I have three options. There's some pretty big leaves here, option one. Option two would be to rip off some paper, I guess, from my book. But option three, which is usually the best option, is to look for garbage around. And I can almost guarantee that somewhere in the vicinity, in a few meters, you will find something perfect. Here's a plastic Kleenex bag. That'll do. Let's see what else we could find. Aha! Excellent. This is a Tim Hortons wrapper that is big enough, sturdy enough. So now you've not only been the responsible dog owner, you've also been the responsible citizen picking up garbage.
Luckily, Keisha is small. My new dog, Oscar, on the other hand.
Yesterday I was in the shed and there was a grocery bag. I think it was there because I think we used it to put shovels and buckets to take to the beach. And I looked at it, I felt it, and it just felt wrong to me. It felt like a foreign substance.
And with that statement, it is clear that doubting Darren's plastic days are done.
This whole legacy of waste, how we're gonna, like, you know, grow old and pass away someday, and we'll have all these products that are left, and many of them toxic, is just so terrible. And with that in mind, I feel like the least we could do is produce as little as possible. But instead, people just, you know, produce almost as much as possible. I happened to be going down a certain street exactly when one of the really loud city garbage trucks, like, pulled up. A polluting, massive, screeching, just terrible, just like a menace to the neighborhood. The noises it was making, and when it had this electric arm kind of came up, and it had this sound where it would, like, screech, like, just, like, the most terrible sound in the world as it, like, crushed stuff down. And I just couldn't stop thinking how this is, like, maybe this is a sign. And I just want to be, like, contributing as little as possible to this.
No longer quitting, are you, Edward?
Single-use plastic is not so fantastic. Use it for a minute or two, and then it sits around for a few thousand years, maybe even more. And then it washes up on the shore. Just bring your own bag to the store. There's no need to be such a fancy pants. Put down the plastic water bottle, give the kids a chance. Cause the next generation is growing. We gotta be knowing if we're consuming. We gotta be doing what we can do to reduce our waste.
Let's see how that next generation is doing.
We were in Mexico for spring break. The one day that was a piñata breaking day. Javon and Owen were both up there. So the piñata broke. Kids wildly came in to grab the candies and the goodies. And Javon had just kind of backed off and didn't take anything. I was like, oh, okay. And then Owen had grabbed a bunch of stuff. And he had been looking at the stuff he'd gotten in his hands. And he was throwing it back. My friend said, you know, why did you put the candies back? And he said, well, they were plastic. I don't want them.
It can be hard. At times, like at school, like sometimes they give out treats and I have to say no. But it's really hard because I see the whole class eating something, but then I can't take it. The other day, her whole class was eating sundaes in the plastic cup and a plastic spoon. I asked her, did you eat one?
I just couldn't help it. I just had to take it.
It's okay, Rose, because most of the time you're still rocking this challenge.
Like if I wanted juice, I would just bring my own container, bring a metal straw, and then say, please can you fill this up with juice or whatever I wanted.
Someone's getting bossy.
This can sound crazy, but you just weigh this in as if it's curry powder. And then when I come back with it full of curry powder, you just subtract the cost of this jar in curry powder.
Hi, how's it going?
I think I'm just gonna get a chicken breast, if that's possible. But can I get it in my own container? That's even simpler. Then some ground beef.
Thank you so much.
Say cheese? As usual, going to a specialty store will serve you best.
If I was to do this correctly, I should go for a cheese that didn't come to you packaged.
There are not that many, but there are some.
I also brought my own wax paper. Can I use that?
Yep.
Okay.
Almost. She puts on disposable plastic gloves specifically for my transaction, which technically therefore belong to my collection. But this time, I don't ask. No way to refuse here. Canada recently switched to plastic money.
I'd say we have closer relationships with a bunch of the local grocers around here. Like, they instantly know who we are. And not in a negative way. Not like, there's the crazy plastic preview. Like, oh, hey, yeah, how's that going? And, and so that's neat. Like, our local seafood place, they're just really mindful and supportive. And once you're set up in your neighborhood or you have your places to go, it's pretty seamless.
When we grocery shop, we don't even look at, like, the coveted things in the middle of the grocery store.
We just go around the outside and then to the till and we're gone.
It's fall, and I have a new man. Nino quit smoking and plastic when we started dating. I know it's love when he comes home smelling like the bulk section, where he had apparently marinated for quite some time.
When you all of a sudden realize, okay, wait a second, 98.9% of our products are in some way enclosed in plastic. And I was like, okay, well, plastic hasn't been around forever, so how did people do this before, right? It must have, you know, like, if Tina can do this, who was my inspiration, I can do this. And it was the challenge, and that got me hooked. And I was constantly trying to find different alternatives, and then the next thing I know, I was like, wait a second, like, I just quit plastic completely, and I was like, and that's it, it was done.
It's nice to have a partner who gets it. We keep each other in check, and also sane, by sharing battle stories.
I sit there and I sip out of my really nice mug, and then I look at people sucking through that tiny little plastic hole in the thing, right? And it's like, really? Like, you're enjoying that?
I have also gained something else. My sense of smell has returned, and I didn't even know it was gone. I can smell like a hound dog. Be it healthier food, natural unscented products, or the lack of plastic itself, plastic-free was the gateway. As nature intended, I can now sense what's good for me. And those sweet smells. Whereas, I can't go near the cleaning product aisle. I get physically nauseous when I smell a dollar store.
Does a smell in here ever bother you? Like a plastic smell?
And I can detect a teenage boy, doused with product, two blocks away.
And I used all sorts of skin creams and makeups, all topped off with a huge cloud of Aquanet. So this was back in the days of big hair. So I recently went and looked up all the ingredients in those products and found I had been exposing myself to 200 chemicals a day before even getting on the school bus. And that's actually pretty typical of a lot of teenagers and for many of us.
The host of chemicals that go into making plastics, whether it's polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride, phthalates, bisphenol A, are all in one way or the other acting as carcinogens or disruptors of our endocrine system. We know that many of these chemicals act like estrogen and other hormones in our body, and it's this twisted mimicking of hormones that creates just the right and indeed the wrong conditions to provoke puberty and for breast cancer to thrive.
There is one other thing, and this may seem trivial to you, but since quitting mascara, I have discovered I can rub my eyes again whenever I want. The great abundance in going without. Plastic free looks good on me.
Freedom!
Even though you might feel like you're being constrained somehow, you're giving up something, that's also opening the door to something else. So step through that, embrace that, you know, enjoy that, and it'll be a lot easier.
And most things in plastic can be seen as luxury because you can do without them.
Most of the plastics, you don't really need them, you know, so it was good to just kind of
you know, get rid of a whole bunch of useless crap.
By simplifying my belongings and all that kind of thing, I am able to regain some sense of peace within, you know, living in a very busy city with a very full life.
Could you live without plastic?
Interesting topic. I'll just give you a new wrinkle here. You know, we've got all these one-cup coffee makers, and you buy little boxes of pre-made coffee enclosed in plastic containers, little tiny ones, okay? And there's zillions of those out there.
Those things drive me insane.
Tell by the look on your face.
Well, it's like, come on, if you're going to drink a fresh cup of coffee, you know, I take beans, I grind them by hand with this wooden and metal grinder. It's a beautiful thing to me, and then I make a fresh cup of coffee. Who wants these, like, kind of gross, single-use plastic
Probably cup? Thousands of office buildings.
Yeah, slow down, guys. Just take a break. Have a good cup of coffee.
Eric, good morning.
I don't really feel like I've given up a lot. Like, I don't feel like I'm deprived. I feel like I've found alternatives that make me happier.
These are really neat. It's a cloth that's covered in beeswax. You just use the heat from your hands to kind of mold it around. Keeps things fresh.
I thought my life would be over. I couldn't eat. No more cereal for me. What am I going to do? What am I going to do? Well, I found a 20-pound thing of porridge. And I thought that I couldn't afford the time to cook them, but I still make it to work.
At some point, you have to be like, do I want to have porridge every day for the rest of my life? Or would I want to get some cereal? I might just have to accept that there's waste with that.
Tonight is Halloween!
Yay! And are you going trick-or-treating?
Yes, but I'm gonna look for stuff that doesn't have plastic. Trick or treat! I cannot take plastic. They didn't have any non-plastic. Trick or treat! I cannot have plastic.
No plastic.
I'm allowed to.
I gave my last non-plastic to Catherine.
That's okay, because I know I won't get that much. Let's go to that house now. See if they have no plastic.
How do you like Crispy Crunch? Good?
Yeah. Okay. I cannot have any plastic.
No plastic?
No plastic.
Wonder Bar or Caramilk or Crispy Crunch?
Are they in plastic?
Yes, they are, aren't they?
Trick or treat!
Who's this? You guys like some treats?
Yes.
There's a peanut butter.
I need to look for something with no plastic.
No plastic? I don't really know what you mean.
Now, you're only allowed to have things like those ones? Okay, here you go. Take a few.
They gave me 2 Smarties.
Oh, okay. Ooh. Smarties saved the day.
Look, it's already packed with no plastic chocolates.
There was no convincing. She knows the deal with the whole refuse plastic thing.
I asked for no straw. So then they came with a straw and these little toys. And I was like, whoa, I asked for no straw.
This is what's happened with most people, is it's become invisible. It wasn't me that noticed it was Giovanna. Mom, this is plastic.
Plastic pollution is polluting the earth with plastic in our landfills, oceans, rivers, forests, beaches, roads, schools, sidewalks, and everywhere.
Which do you like better?
This one.
Now, which one is better for the environment, Owen? Yeah. You know why?
Because it's not plastic.
Some old people can learn from the young.
Not long to go now. What have we old people learned along the way?
It more became a lifestyle, so it more became a way to do things differently, healthier. I mean, the benefits are just ample, and you know, for health, with food, with products that we buy, with chemicals. I mean, it's just, it filters into all areas.
It's not that hard to reduce the bulk of your plastic. Just thinking twice when it's got plastic on it. Do I really need this? Can I avoid it?
It was definitely a lot cheaper, like miles cheaper.
Grocery bill dropped because we're buying dish soap in bulk, toilet paper, and, you know, big
boxes. Everything's in bulk.
I don't need to buy 2 4-liter milks every couple weeks. We use the glass half gallon, and for 4 of us, probably lasts a week. I'm like, am I turning into my mother? Like, well, and that's, you just don't let a drop go to waste. You use every little bit.
Approach it as this, you know, sort of an adventure, just sort of an experiment, and what are you going to learn, or what's going to be interesting?
I've learned the meaning of consumer power. Tested here.
Is it possible to get a sundae in this? And no spoon or anything like that.
What I find interesting is that their money is in my pocket and I'm not giving it up easily.
Success.
Just learning to like let go and be patient and be able to kind of keep open about where you get things or maybe switching things up if you can't find something without plastic. And
considering making it yourself. Some of the stuff we've gotten used to purchasing all the time can be made pretty easily.
Like homemade tortilla chips.
When we started, it felt like things would be really hard and really difficult, but I'm pleasantly surprised to see that it's getting us to think more about living more healthy and I think enjoying ourselves a little bit more now that we're kind of doing our own thing. We made milk and for the first time, which we thought would be impossible, but it took us like in actual work 15 minutes. And it brings up these new challenges, which are fun. It feels good to be self-dependent or only having to kind of live by your own means and do your own thing.
I'm so much happier, and I keep telling everyone who's struggling with weight or struggling with health issues, I said, you need to go on a plastic challenge like I'm doing.
It will only benefit yourself and your family and of course, the environment.
When you've seen the light, packaged food just doesn't seem right.
Knowing where the food comes from, that's huge.
Think of what distance plastic allows from our food in space, time, and perception. Like, when and where did these creatures breathe their last breath? Furthermore, the packaging used during the transport of products is a giant hidden plastic. Hard to refuse when you don't even get to see it. In that sense, just buying less altogether and keeping your purchases close to home are keys to lessening your plastic print.
People got very upset when the BP oil spill happened for very good reason. People thought about, oh my God, this is terrible, this oil, it's in the water, it's going to destroy the living systems there, people are going to be hurt, this is a terrible thing, this oil is going to hurt the people in the Gulf. What people don't think about is, what if the oil had made it safely to shore? What if the oil had actually got where it was trying to go?
The year is coming to an end. It's time now for a few oil spills of our own. How much and what plastics have we all acquired during the year? In my own estimation, I did okay.
That's a lot. Is that quite a bit? That's terrible.
It's bigger and it's fluffy. It's compacted.
It's a couple of bags.
It's bigger than I wish it was.
The challengers keep asking me if I think their piles are big. All I can say is that zero is a noble goal, but it is just as much about where plastic-free takes you. Do it for you while you do it for the planet. There is much to be said about living with at least a little more integrity.
Huh. I don't think we've looked through here.
Gluten-free bread.
Gluten-free bread.
That's kind of a big
cheat. That's a tough one.
And lots of stickers. Yogurt.
This was probably at a party, but I was just like, okay, well, this is our only option, so I'm just gonna take that. One of those days, right? Strange. It's like your dip can't just go on your plate. Chips. Cheese. Chips and cheese. It's organic in a bag.
A lot of milk caps. Yeah.
That looks horrible. That just turns my stomach, actually. Oh, she's found a hidden pocket.
Medium cheddar. Oh, this was a story. Oh, this came
out. Everything's a story. I think that's the best part. She just kept insisting, like, oh, it's fine. I'll just wrap it in this. It's only a little bit of plastic. And the other person there was like, is there a problem over there? And I was just like, oh, no, I'm that person now. Yikes.
I mean, we probably eat tofu, like, once a week. We never found an alternative to it. So.
Bottle tops, olive oil, vinegars, plastic, corks,
if you could call them corks. Eating out containers, cream, we decided never to give up. These little stickers on all the produce. Contact lens solution, obviously we can't say no to that.
This I blame entirely on Brandon. These I blame entirely on Keisha. This one, no recollection. Dry cleaning bag, it was an accident. There's some hidden plastics before I got the Wiser. Here you can see the plastic inside here. Thought these things were foil. Something came in the mail for me. Milk caps, pill packs.
If people saw the amount, like, you know, for example, if everyone had to collect, like carry all their waste around almost like as we're doing, and like just, you know, hoard it and like keep it for a month or whatever it would be. People are like, oh, because they see all the stuff, right? For certain people, it would be nasty, terrifying enough, hopefully, to spark some changes.
Good idea, Edward. The following year, I collect all of one family's plastic that is not on a challenge. I pick a family that calls themselves eco-conscious with their consumer habits. Because if you are watching this movie, this might be you. I want to stress that this is the pile of a family who has already taken some efforts to reduce their plastic.
Welcome to BC Almanac time, eh?
Hi, thanks for having me.
And Susan in Prince George, are you plastic free there?
No, we're not. And that's one of my big concerns.
As much as you can expend all this effort as an individual, I'd like to like take half of it or more and put it into, you know, either supporting political solutions or regulations. And just because every now and then you're doing that, and again, yeah, you're in the checkout and you're busy trying to, you know, live this plastic-free lifestyle. And of course, you know, someone next to you is like, double bag that, please. And you're like, oh, that's undoing what I'm trying to do. And so, I mean, in a way, there's just certain times where you see plastic being used where you go, this is just so ridiculous that we as a society should get together and say, sorry, that's not, you know, that's not acceptable.
To our political leaders and our policy leaders, I say, you cannot educate us out of this apocalyptic problem we have created. You cannot recycle us out of this problem. We challenge you instead to support and adopt source reduction policies and laws that will reduce single-use plastic packaging.
Sometimes I buy something and I end up with more junk than the actual thing. And there's this plastic clamshells that you need like a chainsaw to cut through. They are so inconvenient, they're so ugly. This plastic that you try to crumble into your garbage and springs back out, who chooses that?
The plastic industry needs to provide take-back infrastructure. We need extended producer responsibility. If you can't take it back and reuse it, don't make it.
We attempted the pendulum thing, so we were like going full on to realize the absurdity of how we're all living.
I don't think I'll ever go back to like a to-go cup or like a plastic water bottle.
Or like using a shopping bag.
Like a cloud of shame as I'm walking out. I don't think I could do it.
I am always embarrassed for people I see with those saggy sacks, because plastic bags are the lowest of the low-hanging fruit, and the least anyone can do for themselves is not look like a total fool carting one.
I don't think we'll be plastic angels. I don't think we'll be quite as intense as we have been this past year, but I think that we'll generally continue.
And we'll always be so much more aware of the waste that we produce.
It'll be interesting to see, because I worry that it's a slippery slope. We just go back to grabbing boxes and packages of things, but I don't think that'll happen yet.
I love it, and I hope it continues and just gets better and better.
I mean, a year long, you know, that is a little bit daunting, but at the same time, yeah, I think it was just, why not?
Thank you for like bringing us on and letting us be part of it. It was really cool, really memorable.
Thank you for inviting us on this journey.
Yeah, so at least I get to part ways with this stuff now, I guess.
Someone gave me a hero award.
Yeah, well, every year I enter films in My Hero Film Festival,
And I do it on heroes that are making a difference, like you.
Why would you choose someone that's going without plastic as your hero?
Because I just think it's something that everyone can do.
There was just one thing about the award.
The shiny plastic cover.
Oh.
And someone gave me a kiss.
Yeah.
All right. We're so wrapped up in our products and are using these products that we don't have any time to develop our own personalities. We become just an appendage of the economic paradigm, which is one of consumption. So you're only defined as your brand. This whole branding thing is just out of control, and it removes any individuality in the person. The individual is yet to be created. The individual has to rise out of this soup of products. To do that, you need to reduce your consumption to get away from this harried lifestyle that doesn't leave any room for the self, you know, for development of the personality. So I think that you could expect to find personal development to come out of reduction of plastic use.
Captain, I agree. Convenience is not what makes life colorful. Shortly after the challenge, Nino and I flee the city and purchase a plot of forest on a small island. Basically, to get away from it all and to be closer to our food. A recent study showed that 100% of pregnant women sampled had plastic chemicals in their umbilical cord blood. Chemicals with serious consequences for the unsuspecting subjects.
When the exposures took place, all of them looked like this. This was the first time since the beginning of the chemical revolution a century ago that anyone had ever bothered to look and see if the chemicals in the environment absorbed by the mother were passed through to the child. And the bottom line is, of course, profoundly disturbing. Chemical pollution, plastic chemical pollution, begins in the womb. We found hundreds of chemicals in these newborns, and we found dozens of chemicals used in plastics.
I have a small boy now. I am more than happy to have been on a plastic diet on my son's behalf, so that he has been as plastic-free as possible, right from conception. Plus, to have future generations have to turn away in disgust from our ocean and beaches would be the greatest sadness. I will continue to set a good example for him, and for what it's worth, I'll be able to tell him that at least I tried. What will you say?
Once upon a dream, the whales splashed, the eagles flew, the frogs hopped. Then everything changed. I wish those days were back with me. How much I miss them badly. Memories are carried on the eagle's wings, remembering yesterday.
You don't have to miss me.
I'll take the alleyway today. No need for streets, I just compete with other people. Walking side by side on sidewalks with their clocks all ticking simultaneously. That's where I a secret way.